some drainage in the back here.
That's good.
That's good, yeah. So I noticed in some of the Facebook groups, I'm talking to the camera now. So some of the Facebook groups, people were posting stuff like this red mark. Now that's not uncommon or anything, that's fine. So when we get to the heat, we're gonna melt that down and get a lot of secretion out of there. And it might still be a little bit red after, but that goes away. So a lot of people are concerned about, you know, when it gets inflamed and red like that, that's just some of the lactic fluid that's in there, that's stuck in there, waiting to get drained out.
It does feel good.
The warm, yeah.
Yeah.
A lot of people say, I like the warm a lot better than the cold. Me, I kind of like the cold.
Yeah.
The cold is kind of soothing.
It soothes the muscles and...
Yeah.
I always have a lower back that I have to, you know, be careful with, so this feels good on that.
Can you eat the popsicle here?
Apple. You know, one of those little things you pour the juice in, whatever,
yep.
And so we have one of those. We did it with strawberry milk and chocolate milk last night. And we put it in the freezer, and I don't know, 20 minutes later or so, the power went out.
Oh.
So we never got to eat them last night. It's like butter again?
Yeah.
See the skin tightening up around the muscle.
Oh, yeah?
Bones.
Good.
Yeah. Super slippery, that's what we're looking for. When you're working with a cryo T-shock or cryo skin, anything that's slippery, that's where you want to work. That's how you know you're getting the drainage. Work where it's slippery. So factory settings work pretty good for you, time-wise. Although the factory settings on the fat removal, the second round of heat is only set for 2 minutes, and I usually up that to 8 to 10, because that's when you're going to get most of the drainage, is in the heat section. The second round of heat, after you freeze it.